Remember that the forward inference of hidden Markov model is a repeated procedure of prediction and correction. As the first half of this procedure, let's look at how well can we predict into future without evidence. Let's suppose that at time zero, we are 100% certain that X is in state zero. Since in hidden Markov model, there is a probability to switch to other states in future times, intuitively, we tend to be more and more uncertain that we'll remain in state zero as time goes. In other words, without evidence, we are going to forget about the past state in a changing world. The higher the switching rate or transition probability is, the faster we will forget. To see this point, let's generate some random sequences from the Markov chain we just built in exercise 1. Here, assuming we are in state 0 in the beginning, and we have 1% chance to switch at each time step. As you can see, in the first few steps, we are still pretty sure we will stay in state 0. But as time goes, we will be more and more uncertain which state we are in. Actually, the probability of being in state 0 decays exponentially from 1 to 1/2 over time. Because the number of future passes grows exponentially with time. And if we look backward, the contribution of the initial state will decrease exponentially. Mathematically, this can be calculated, the probability can be calculated using the probability propagation relation of the Markov chain, which you have already seen in yesterday's tutorial. Please note that in this tutorial, Aij means the transition probability from I to j, and this is the opposite of the convention used in the intro. In exercise 2, you will inspect how we forget about the initial state over time in a changing world. Using the model you just defined in exercise 1, let's assume we are always in state 0 at initial time. In this exercise, you'll need to complete the code to calculate the predictive probability of xt using the recursion equation just mentioned, as shown here. After that, use our provided code to visualize how probabilities propagate over time in a Markov chain. If the switching probability is small, you should see an exponential decay from 1 towards 1/2, like the one in the last slide. What if the switching probability is large? In this case, we're almost certain that we will switch to the other state at next time. So if you plot the probability of state 0 over time, you will see a damping oscillation of that. Please try different values of switching probabilities ranging from 0 to 1 and trying to understand how that affects the curve of predictive probabilities.